Brother just got extensions put in today.
Oh my fucking God. This nigga got a fucking rat on his fucking head. Oh my fucking goodness. Oh my God. Bro, this shit looks stupid as fuck, bro.
Tight, huh?
Bro.
Between your eyes?
I'm in a field of dreams and dances with wolves.
Nickel, you are a wolf.
Mm. Wait, hold on. Let me see the other picture. Oh.
Hell no.
Brother, just...
Look at the picture that he put up there. And look at the picture of him. I ain't gonna lie. This is what motherfuckers be doing on them dating sites, bro. No cap, bro. They putting the best pictures of them and shit. Boy, you meet a motherfucker from them dating sites, bro, and them motherfuckers be ugly as fuck, bro. Hey, I'm gonna be honest, bro. Man, bro, I had met this one girl off Tinder, bro. I met her off Tinder, bro. This is back when I was driving a Jag, bro. I had an old Jag, right? And I met her. She stayed like in Pearland, bro. Man. I go pick Shorty up. First of all, it's low-key raining outside. And she comes to the whip. And she's sitting in the car. And first of all, she way bigger than what I expected. But she wasn't fat, though. She wasn't fat. Her pinky made her look skinny. But, nigga, I look over and I'm like... Bro, I'm looking at it like this. And as soon as she got in this car, I'm sitting here thinking... I got to get her out. I swear to God. I was like, I got to get her out, bro. She got to get out, bro. Because what you did was so disrespectful, bro. L Riz, not gonna lie. And also, too, I'm gonna be honest. Her motherfucking teeth were crazy. Her teeth. It's like, bro, if you would have kept it real with a nigga, bro, I probably could have kicked it with you, whatever. But yo, you look so different. So I'm looking at, I'm at like, who is you again? Like, I'm like, and like, her, the thing about her teeth, she had one big ass, like her front tooth, one of them was extra big, bro.
We here would like to offer our services to Tina Luther King to help aid on her case.
No, you don't.
We will be representing her and her movement in the controversial for her eyes only bill. If you or anyone you know has been affected, you may be entitled to cash.
You're not entitled to shit, bro. You're not entitled to shit, bro.
I'm surprised you didn't say this dreadhead was your cousin.
That's kind of racist. Why would that be my cousin? Because he got dreads? I've never said nothing like that, Cash. That's kind of racist. That's kind of racist, bro. You got to FaceTime before you meet him? Yeah. I ain't gonna lie though, but at that time, bro, I just got back from El Paso. It was a dry spell because all the girls that I talked to was in another city. I'm back home. Back at college, I didn't talk to nobody from high school. So I'm back home. I ain't talking to nobody. I was just trying to get some ass, bro. I'ma just tell you the truth, bro. I'ma just tell you the truth, bro. And if she would have low-key looked semi-decent, matter of fact, not even semi-decent, nigga, if she would have low-key looked somewhat like the person in the picture, I probably would have tried to hit it. But, bro, she came to this hoe like, her hair wasn't even really done type shit, but it was raining, though, so I gave her credit for that, but I'm like, I got to get her out, nigga. A nigga like me would have still fucked. I ain't gonna lie. Hey, nah, I'm gonna share too much. hey, no count. And to get her out, I had to act like I really fucked with her, bro. I had to like, because she wouldn't like getting the vibe that like you fucked that bitch. I promise I didn't fuck her, bro. She wouldn't get the vibe that I wanted her out the car. I'm not rude about my shit. I'm like, I don't be rude to people. Being rude is fucked up. But I was low-key telling her, like, nah, I'ma hit you, though. Like, but knowing the whole time I'm not finna hit you back, bro. I'm like, nah, you wildin', bro. Of course, bro, I got you, bro. Yeah, I'ma hit you, bro. Real shit. See, nah, you playing. You not gonna cop. I'm like, what the fuck you mean I ain't gonna... I'm like, hold on. Now it's you that ain't gonna hit me then because you trying to switch shit. You trying to switch. In my head, I'm like, bro, get out, please. I know I'm dry, but this is too dry, bro. I know I'm dry, but this is too dry, bro. Bro, niggas say, nah, for real, I can't ever bring myself to kick a bitch out. Yo, Uzi, hey, real nigga shit, bro. Real nigga shit. Bro, I'm not that damn mean to kick a bitch out for real, bro. I be low-key trying to find a way so she can kick herself out, bro. I be like, look, some, yo, niggas on the internet be capping, yeah, I kick that bitch out. That shit not really that easy, though, bro. Because, like, bro, we really be some nice niggas, though, so you just can't kick her out on some, like, nah, you gotta go shit. Bro, I be like, damn. I'm tired than a bitch. What you about to get into? I'm like, damn, low-key. Yeah, hey, I gotta drive across town in the morning early type shit. Bro, that's the vibe. That mean get out, please, baby. Vibe, baby, that mean get out, bro. Bro, that mean go, bro. Takes a homeboy to call you. Oh, God, I did that shit, bro. Yo, I gotta tell a story on that, bro. Like, a bitch come to my room and she on some bullshit, I'ma just stop talking to her and she leave. Yo, hey, so look. I'm going to tell y'all a story time about when I met this goddamn girl at the club in El Paso, Texas. I think I told y'all this story before, bro. Look, I think I told y'all this story. I was in El Paso, Texas.